views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The truth is funny. With Colette Stefan, we'll have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network as she provides energetic shifts and consistent results in every area of life, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success. Many people who shift out of limiting beliefs roar with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. The truth is funny. Shift happens. Feel instant relief. Stay tuned for more fun and release struggle and suffering. And now, here's your host, Colette Stefan.
Hi, this is Colette Marie Stefan. Welcome to The Truth is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio. Stay tuned for the next hour and experience instant relief as you allow your intuition to work for you. Shift happens every Wednesday morning at 8 o'clock a.m. live on the radio waves and in the archives at thetruthisfunny.com and also at transformationtalkradio.com. And the energetic shifts are still accessible through what I call HSN, the Higher Self Network, if you're listening later. So I've been using this radio show as a vehicle to have people be able to call in and experience what it's like to have something that's bothering them or an issue that's, you know, in any area of life, and just see how easily we can find creative solutions and to whatever problems just by getting neutral to the problem and energetically shifting it. And so I've been working with a lot of my favorite energy practitioners, and I have Will Hatch here on the show with me today. I also have another guest here, my cat Pearl, because she's sitting right here. So if you hear a loud purring noise, that's her expressing her love, I guess, through the radio waves. And so, Will, are you there?
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
Pretty awesome.
Good.
The sun isn't shining yet, but we've got this beautiful blanket of fog over us today.
Yeah, that's what it was like here yesterday. We got a bit of snow, and then we got some rain, and it's nice and fresh out there. It's going to be a sunny day. It's supposed to go and get really warm today. So we've been, you know, the last time you were on the show, we were talking about creating reality. I mean, did we just get back from Peru on the last show?
Yeah, the last show was about Peru.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because you and I, do you want to just talk a little bit about that? You know, what we, about Peru and you know, your that, and then we'll move towards the topic
sure.
today.
Sure. So it was kind of interesting coming into Peru. You know, we started out saying, where do we put our energy? And we started saying, let's really sit back and be responsible for what we create. And then we went to Peru, and we put a whole bunch of energy into what we've been creating, and we came back and celebrated it. And now here we are, another 6 weeks later, and we're kind of accounting.
Yeah, you and I were really talking about this. I was saying to you, I had several clients this week that were weak to leap year. And I was like, wow, like, what's that about? And I, you know, I said to you, I really want to address this for people because honestly, I never had really come across it before, or not consciously anyway, that, mm-hmm. that people would have an issue that on, you know, February 29th, that only happens every 4 years. And so it's kind of interesting. The energy around that was that, you know, that's the year that, you know, do you know why there is a leap year?
Not a clue. Just wondering that.
Well, I from what I understand, it's because of the slight variation in the math of, like, you know, over that 4 year period, we actually gain an extra day. Because,
oh, I knew that. Like, it's 365 and a quarter days, but I'm looking for the real reason. I don't have a clue what that is.
Yeah. Maybe I've talked to some people, like, when I was working with them this week and energetically shifting this, and they didn't know what leap year was. like they didn't re- like they didn't know why they have a leap year. And I said, it's kind of like it comes up that it's like fudging the numbers, you know,
mm-hmm.
that, you know, that this isn't a real day every 4 days. And I had a little boy sick, you know, almost like with a real high fever and coughing. And this was his weakness. He was weak to leap year. And so, you know, what are you picking up around that? For the people listening in, let's shift it.
It's kind of interesting because essentially what this quarter day is doing over the course of the 4 years is it's putting the equinox in its four positions at a different time of day through the cycle, right?
Mm-hmm.
So here we are at the peak of the cycle with 366 days. So the equinox is, you know, if I divide that up into four, should be starting off at the beginning of the day, the middle of the day, after the middle of the day, and then at the very end of the day. It should be balanced on this year, if I'm guessing right.
Cool. So that the idea that's, of them
that's
calling
an even
it,
flow.
Yeah, because what I was getting is that in the leap year, it's kind of like taking a leap. Like a leap of faith almost is what's coming up. And when you consider that, you know, every leap year is only like four, like that we experience a certain amount of leap years in our lifetime. And I'm getting this, you know, we just want to shift this for everybody, like, because it really is coming up. It was coming up week almost, I'm getting, for 60 to 75% of the population. And so,
oh, it's the third of the new millennia as well.
Okay, and yes, and we also have a solar eclipse coming up on March 9th. So there's all these there's just been so many astrological factors that are coming in right now, and it's just, you know, the whole planet feels kind of like that. And, you know, you and I were talking about, because, like, I've been all this week, I've been shredding paper. And, you know, I'm shredding 2006, 2007, 2008. And while I'm shredding all this paper, because I don't need to keep it anymore for income tax reasons, while I'm shredding all these boxes of paper, I'm correcting what happened in those years. Like, I'm looking at all the receipts. I'm looking at all the, you know, the different, like, you can really kind of log into your life by going through your files, what was going on in your life in one particular year. And quite often I'm getting that a lot of people at this time of year, because they are dealing with income tax and they're dealing with accounting, the word accounting weakens people, because you have to account for what you didn't get done, right?
It's judgment and accountability.
Okay, so
on top of that.
So, you know, what do you feel like that's like, what's the judgment about?
We're always worried about judgments because we've only got so much time to get it right.
That we're aware of. And so, you know, when it comes to time, like, we're really traveling on, you know, different dimensions, existences, time and space. And so a lot of times there's, like, you know, when people talk about past lives, I really consider those kind of like just little, you know, choices that we make steer our life into different paths.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, we could choose one path or we can choose another path. And where people get weak is they don't recognize if they have too many paths. I find that's when they really get triggered. And I get this, what's happening is on leap year, you know, it's one of those things where it doesn't feel, it is to even things out, but it doesn't feel even is what's coming up. It feels odd.
Yeah.
So we just want to correct that. We're just getting in touch with the energetic weaknesses that we can feel around the leap year thing and around this time of year when we're, you know, a lot of people are shredding paper right now. And so.
So as you're talking, this is like coming up as simply just the fear of letting go. How do I get what I want? I have to let go of what I don't want first.
Yeah, and that's what we want to talk about. We have a quick break coming up here right away, and we want to talk about that. You know, what are we creating with our thoughts? What are we creating energetically? What are we feeling? And so we'll talk about that when we get back. I also wanted everybody to know, I forgot to mention that you can call in at 1-800-930-2819 if you have an issue or something that's bothering you. We'd be happy to energetically shift that for you. We'll be right back to make some more shift happen.
Hello, mother. Hello, father. Here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining. And they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining. I went hiking with Joe Spivey. He developed poison ivy. You remember Leonard Skinner. He got ptomaine poisoning last night after dinner.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people in living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
What are vibes? We often use this word, but did you know vibes can actually be useful and help solve our everyday challenges? Embark on an exciting learning journey with Caitlin Keat, 11-time Visionary Award winner, specialist in vibrational energy, and the creator of Vibes Up. Join Caitlin as she takes you through the world of vibrational therapy and energy healing with natural solutions for a modern world. Visit vibesup.com to learn more today.
A word of caution, if you prefer the status quo and you are not interested in improving every aspect of your life, this book will trigger the shift out of you. The Truth is Funny, Shift Happens is available now. Author Colette Stefan brings the powerful knowledge and life-changing energy and empowerment from the radio airwaves to the pages of her new book. To get your copy in paperback or ebook, visit thetruthisfunny.com today.
Hi everyone, this is Dr. Pat. The ancient Inca root vegetable maca is world-renowned for its wide array of health benefits. As a family-run company of true maca specialists, the maca team's mission is to provide you with fresh, organic, premium-quality maca powders at a fair price. Amazing. All of the products are always organically grown, fair-traded, GMO-free, fresh, and potent. So don't take my word for it. Experience the life-changing benefits of maca today. Visit themacateam.com.
Are you ready for a game changer? Sarah Westall is bringing you Business Game Changers Radio. Sarah brings you leading experts, visionaries, and newsmakers who provide the best commentary on big issues and cutting-edge innovations. Sarah's 20 years as a business executive will help you think like an entrepreneur with expertise, energy, and attitude. Tune in to Business Game Changers Mondays at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Almost everyone at some time in their lives ask themselves, what am I? Most of our questions are ego-generated and simply don't address the problem of our false self. It's time to relax your ego and embody your soul. Dr. Dan Cohen, neurologist, inventor, and author, has created tools to awaken, a new way to transform from who you thought you were into what you truly are. Visit toolstoawaken.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Think of your fellow man, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see, it's getting late. Oh, please don't hesitate.
We're back on The Truth is Funny with Colette Marie Stefan, and my guest today, Will Hatch. And
hi.
Will, before we continue, will you just share your contact information?
No. Why not?
No.
Why should I? I did it before. Thoughts, THOUGHTS, at Thisagree, thisagree.ca, because I'm in Canada and I couldn't get .com.
That's awesome. You know, you and I were just laughing because Brian chose this wonderful piece of music and it kind of reminded us about hiking in the jungle. And, you know, sometimes people, you know, when I think been 6 weeks since we returned from Peru, and I'm very excited to announce like a bunch of, you know, real cool things are happening for me. And I want to put some of that energy out there for everybody else. One thing that we have all the video edited. Thank you, Miriam, for that. And we are for our online program. And so we'll have our online program for energetic upgrade seminars out at the end of March here. And we're really excited about that. Yeah. Now, there was one thought. And then another thing that's happening in my life that is really amazing and makes me so happy is that I had 9 years ago started painting these dragons from, you know, big dragon paintings, and I have to date 17. And when I got, you know, they've been sitting for 9 years, and people keep saying, Colette, bring them out. And I keep saying, okay, I will. And then I get busy doing seminars, and I was writing a book, and now we're doing that. So Tales from the Vector will be out soon too. And that's with these paintings, and they're actually part of an oracle. And that oracle, like each of these cards is energetically encoded to shift energy around, yeah, to create and to, you know, put some I don't want to say positive energy into the environment, but put an intention into the environment that is beneficial to everybody in the environment. And so I'm really excited about this. I'm actually right after this radio show, they're all I packed them all up and they're off to go and get scanned, and then, you know, we'll be able to put them out there right away. And I was saying to you this morning that, you know, herding dragons is like herding cats. Dragon paintings. It took me quite a while to do. So, you know, that's kind of the good news that I have, you know, that the online program coming out. And, you know, I'm really excited about this because also heading off to go back to Germany and share this information with Mark, you know, this month. You can find information about that at www.energeticupgrade.com. And then I'll be going to Germany, and then Mark will be coming here in October of this year, and we will be teaching a seminar in Vancouver. So all of this has been happening since we got back from Peru. It's been like really amazing and awesome. And so I want to share that with people, that, you know, that energy, the excitement, and it's been so much fun. And so I just wanted to, you know, talk to you about that, like, you know, because, you know, you've been shifting and we've been working together quite a bit, and this has really been shifting in a really beautiful way. So what are you doing? Well, what do you recommend?
Well, I've been reading a lot of ancient texts lately, over this last year, I guess. And I've really been asking the hard questions. If I can engineer a cell phone and the latest and greatest transistors that Intel doesn't even offer you in a computer chip yet, then how can I engineer the rest of my world? So the one thing that's really coming to mind through all this is a very misunderstood phrase, as above, so below. And what it's really trying to tell us is that everything is a reflection. So what you see outside is what's inside. So when we're creating these things, it's so easy for us to look at the world in front of us and tell us that that is what is. And that's where we all get stuck. The hardest part of this is expecting something different, even though you might be doing almost the exact same thing.
You know, they say that's the definition of insanity.
Oh, I think Einstein has that backwards, actually. He doesn't really take into account that when we're dealing with quantum things, that the observer influences the experiment. And so expecting the same thing to happen every time? No, that is insanity.
So either way, you're insane.
Pretty much.
Well, you know, but Einstein, you know, he was dyslexic.
Exactly.
But
so where I'm going with this,
there is like a duality. There's always that duality.
Yeah, and so where I'm going with this is that it's really easy for us to look at the outside influences and say, that's what's stopping me from being where I want to be, is all these things. Look at all these things. That's what's holding me back. Can't you see? Can't you see? Can't you see? But then in that statement, we're really failing to acknowledge that what's inside is what's created and what's outside. And so what I challenge people to do when I'm working with them is to tell me a story. Tell me why your life is what it is. Tell me what's holding you back from what you want, that thing you want so bad that for whatever reason hasn't manifested itself. It sure isn't for lack of wanting. Tell me why you don't have that. And then I listen. And what I notice is there's always some very specific words that people use to tell me about the things that are coming up and coming into their existence that are stopping everything from happening. And then I often ask people what they're trying to create and what we're doing in order to get there. And when I listen to the verbiage that people use, it's often we're putting ourselves in this position of, oh, this is work. Oh, this is unpleasant. Oh, problems, 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 even though we didn't have any problems to begin with. And it's that story we tell ourselves that I'm learning more and more is the brightest indication we have of what's inside. And it explains perfectly what we see on the outside, but that's our reality that we're creating right there. So how do we change it?
And this is like, so this is coming up over and over and over again with a lot of people. You know, we're in this, Mark and I were just speaking yesterday on Skype, and I think it's available. You can find it on Mark Kettenbach Coaching, but he'd put a video out from Peru, and he's talking in it about, you know, how we need to kind of focus on, when we're in our reality, focusing on what we experience just ourselves, not focusing on what other people experience through watching TV or through reading newspapers or any of that, that we focus on and only talk about just for one day, even things that actually have occurred in our own experience. And what you start to notice when you do that is that, you know, a lot of the problems that are out there, a lot of the fear that is out there has really very little to do with me and my world. For one thing, though, I mean, I haven't had a TV for 9 years. And so that, you know, that makes a big difference for me. You know, TV has a lot, you know, a lot of people, it's not, you know, if you're going to have a TV in your home, be aware that of what, you know, what the energy that of what you're watching is putting in your home. This is really coming up as physical environment right now. I talk about this a lot, you know, how important it is. And, you know, it's really funny because what I've been noticing with a lot of people right now is they think that they have to do things a certain way because that's the way that logically that they were told, okay, you have to do it this way. And one of the things that we have been told, most of us, is that, you know, if we get the education and then we get the job, then we will be able to make the money and find the partner and maybe have children or whatever, and we'll live happily ever after. We'll be doing, you know, that's how we get happy. And in actual fact, if you are happy, which usually happens when you are in balance, you know, and enjoying your life and having fun and doing things that inspire you from your heart, not, you know, letting go of the shoulds and the woulds and the coulds and being, you know, and doing what makes your heart sing. When you do those things and you're happy, then you attract happy situations to you.
Exactly.
And, you know, and that, you know, it's so funny because, I had asked you to build me a fish deck, and everybody says, fish deck? What's a fish deck? So you got to go to Facebook, call The Truth is Funny with Colette, and I posted it on there and on my private page because people are going, what is a fish deck? And I said, a fish deck is a deck that's shaped like a fish. So you can see it there. And that every time I look out at the fish deck, it just makes me happy. And when I'm happy, I work faster and more efficiently. And, you know, my energetic shifting is much more efficient. So you are listening to Colette Marie Stefan, and we are available at thetruthisfunny.com and on social media, Facebook and Twitter at The Truth is Funny with Colette. Call in if you want an opportunity to shift your life into better. 1-800-930-2819. We'll be right back to make some more shift happen.
Just an old-fashioned love song playing on the radio, and wrapped around the music is the sound of someone promising they'll never go. You swear you've heard it before as it slowly rumbles on.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people in living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
What are vibes? We often use this word, but did you know vibes can actually be useful and help solve our everyday challenges? Embark on an exciting learning journey with Caitlin Keat, 11-time Visionary Award winner, specialist in vibrational energy, and the creator of Vibes Up. Join Caitlin as she takes you through the world of vibrational therapy and energy healing with natural solutions for a modern world. Visit vibesup.com to learn more today.
A word of caution, if you prefer the status quo and you are not interested in improving every aspect of your life, this book will trigger the shift out of you. The Truth is Funny, Shift Happens is available now. Author Colette Stefan brings the powerful knowledge and life-changing energy and empowerment from the radio airwaves to the pages of her new book. To get your copy in paperback or ebook, visit thetruthisfunny.com today.
Get into it for 2016. Do you want more prosperity, clarity, energy, and balance in your life? Join Lynn Brown now through March for one of her amazing workshops, each focusing on a key part of living your best life. For more information and to register for one of these amazing workshops, visit lynnbrownevent.com. That's lynnbrownevent.com. And get into it this 2016 with Lynn Brown.
Are you ready for a radical shift in your way of being? Are you seeking a more deeply connected and fulfilling life? Awakened Living Radio is a show dedicated to helping you embrace a life filled with profound peace, connection, and happiness. TJ Woodward is passionate about helping you find your clarity, balance, and purpose. Join co-host TJ Woodward and Dr. Pat Basile on the first Monday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific Time for Awakened Living Radio on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
I am Colette Marie Stefan, and you are listening to The Truth is Funny. I have Will Hatch here with me today. Feel free to call in 1-800-930-2819. We are talking about what we're creating with our energy. And just before the break, you know, I was saying to you, Will, that a lot of people are emailing and saying, can you shift some energy around the flu? And so I'm like, yeah, I can do that. Personally, I don't believe in the flu. So I'm just going to strengthen that for everybody. The flu comes up energetically, grief. And you said that right away. And when I tested, what's the grief? Well, because the market, because the financial markets have been so unstable lately, you know, you know, everybody's worried about the economy and all of that, the stock market, all of that, that energy coming up. That is the energy that is kind of bothering people when they get in touch with this. So we want to strengthen for everybody, you know, any finances to your spiritual and spiritual to your finances is what's coming up as a weakness. And we want to be in a position where we recognize that, you know, the way that people define success, you know, how do you define success? The flu is kind of like a sadness. A grief of it's coming up, the accounting. And so a lot of people at this time of year are getting credit card bills coming in from Christmas. And or they've gone on a holiday and now they've returned from it. Now it's back to work. You know, if they're lucky, they've gone on a vacation.
And on top of that, there's also the element that we're accounting for last year. Well, we're trying to let go of last year and move on to this next year coming up. And so we're really caught in the middle.
That is huge. Like that is exactly what I was picking up this morning, because we left 2015 and 2016 is a 9 year. It's about finality. It's about reaping the benefits of all your work and then getting everything in place for this next decade, basically, and moving into this next decade with, you know, and the more organized you are with your finances, the more organized you are in your home, the more organized you are with your business, everything, you're showing the universe that you're ready to, you know, bring in more money, bring in more abundance, bring in more health, wealth, happiness, basically. And so we really want to strengthen this, because it's coming up, the profound grief that people are feeling right now about kind of what's going on, the accounting for what's going on in the world around us, because, you know, we're creating that reality. So we have a caller here. Will, did you want to say any last words about before we take this call, or do you want to just say some
just
last
breathe.
Words?
And when you breathe, just be glad that you can do that, and everything else will follow.
Good. That's good advice. A lot of people actually do hold their breath when they are triggered. And quite often it'll come up as a weakness in the solar plexus.
Yes.
And it'll be like you're quite often from the subconscious mind, you know, the limiting beliefs that we, you know, were created in our childhood, basically. So we're just going to shift that for everybody, like letting that go, recognizing that in that moment, that if you have the flu right now, one thing I can tell you is, you know, if you've got the fever and you've, you know, and you're vomiting and you've got diarrhea, which, you know, and the ache, you know, some of us pay good money to go to the jungle and do that. But we don't call it the flu. We call it ceremony. And so, you know, before I, you know, experience that for myself, I didn't realize that, you know, how effective purging can be in and how people can really resist that. And so the flu is one way that, you know, our body helps us to eliminate the emotions and the not just emotions, but the thoughts. It's coming up psychic and psychic energy, you know, things from inside and outside. So we just want to let that all go and move forward in this year in a strong way, not laying in bed with the flu. That's my advice for everyone. There we go. And we do have Liz here from San Diego, California. Liz, are you there?
Yeah. Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Well, Colette, you had said I might either email you an update or call into the radio show because we worked together. I called in last week, and then we worked on the phone. So part of it is to just tell everyone how fabulous working with this woman is, the energy shifts.
Thank you.
We were just laughing so hard when we both kind of realized that it seemed like all our clients were children from other lives that we were... and realize we were trying to parent, or at least I was.
Because I told you as I was shifting the energy for you around that I was picking, I was at that exact moment shredding 2000 registration forms of clients from seminars from 2006. So it's kind of funny. So what I started to do is energetically shift each person as I was shredding them. I just want to make sure that I wanted to make sure their information was safe, right? And so, but as I was putting this through, I was like sending love and energy to all the people that I have ever shared this information with. It was fun.
It's sort of exactly as what you said. There is there had been such a long-standing, kind of energetic drain around my my work with clients. I'm a professional organizer, so I had to smile when I heard you talking about how it helps to be organized. And it was just almost that, I love doing that kind of work, and I love the people I work with, but I didn't know how to do it without taking on their challenges or problems as if they were mine. And it just... I hadn't even distinguished it for a while. It just seemed like the normal, stress of working.
Address this because, it was, we had a lot of conversations about this the week before, and we were shifting a lot of energy around this, what people take on from outside of themselves. It's incredible.
You're in a very special spot because you're on the absolute threshold of the ultimate dream, which is complete freedom, working from at home in your underwear sometimes and being able to go out at your freedom doing something that you love. Now where the resistance starts to come in, and I notice with people, is that exactly what I was saying earlier. How do we tell the story? And when I hear you telling me the story about this thing that you're telling me you absolutely love, you're passionate about, this is your sort of doing that thing that feeds your soul and takes care of other people on so many different levels. That's exactly where you want to be. But I'm hearing you talk about it like it's work. And you're here to have fun.
I like that, Peter.
if you want to go to work, you could do that anywhere, but you're here because you found something you love and you want to have fun.
Yeah, and when you look at it from that perspective, and this is what you and I were talking about last week, Will, is that, like, if I look at, I love my work. There's certain aspects of my work, like little jobs within my work that, the computer stuff and all of that. So I'm just, looking, strengthening to have a team. And it's really funny. I'll share this with you. Like, it's kind of a funny story because the more that you work with your clients like this, Liz, and you have like this real, like, strong recognition that, the more neutral you are to them and the less you treat them like your children, the better off everyone's going to be and the more efficient you are going to be in your work. And just because you yourself, it takes the pressure off people a little bit and or a lot, that other people's problems are really not your problems, but you are more than happy to find a solution. And I just love that you're organizing, and this is something that you and I had spoken of, and it's coming up right now, is that the reason why organization is so important is because, I had said to you, Liz, every child, do you agree every child should have a neat and tidy room, or the opportunity to have a neat and tidy room. And some of us have, you know, messes that are very creative, and a lot of geniuses work with a mess. But it's important to be able to know that, you know, when it's time, that you can put things back into place so that you can kind of put that creativity back into your system again, is what I'm getting, to refeed it. We have to take a break here, but if you want to hang on, Liz, we'll check in with you again when we come back, and Will and I will do just check and see how you're doing. This is Colette. We'll be right back to make some more shift happen.
Mother, hello father, here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining, and they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining. I went hiking with Joe Spivey, he developed poison ivy. You remember Leonard Skinner, he got ptomaine poisoning last night after dinner.
A word of caution. If you prefer the status quo and you are not interested in improving every aspect of your life, this book will trigger the shift out of you. The Truth is Funny, Shift Happens is available now. Author Colette Stefan brings the powerful knowledge and life-changing energy and empowerment from the radio airwaves to the pages of her new book. To get your copy in paperback or ebook, visit thetruthisfunny.com today.
Get into it for 2016. Do you want more prosperity, clarity, energy, and balance in your life? Join Lynn Brown now through March for one of her amazing workshops, each focusing on a key part of living your best life. For more information and to register for one of these amazing workshops, visit lynnbrownevent.com. That's lynnbrownevent.com. And get into it this 2016 with Lynn Brown.
Are you ready for a radical shift in your way of being? Are you seeking a more deeply connected and fulfilling life? Awakened Living Radio is a show dedicated to helping you embrace a life filled with profound peace, connection, and happiness. TJ Woodward is passionate about helping you find your clarity, balance, and purpose. Join co-host TJ Woodward and Dr. Pat Basile on the first Monday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific Time for Awakened Living Radio on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman, as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
You got attitude? Keys to the rescue. Adjust your attitude with Keys Clear Protein Waters. So refreshing. Just a few sips of Keys will give you a whole new outlook, thanks to 22 grams of the happiest protein on earth. Tongue-tingling tasty without the guilt of naughty or nasty ingredients. If that doesn't put a smile on your face, maybe you need to drink too. Put a little woohoo in your attitude with Keys Protein Water. On Amazon or at Keys, K-E-E-S, please, .com.
This is Colette Marie Stefan. You're listening to The Truth is Funny. I have Will Hatch with me here today, and we also have Liz, who's calling in from California. And, you know, thank you so much for all the compliments, Liz. Will has some, wants to, we were working on this, and he has something to share with you around this, and that I think will be very beneficial for everyone listening in.
So the one last little bit of cleanup that I could see on this issue before we got to the break is just to remind all of us that, you know, this whole healing and growth, it always comes from within, right? And so when you're working with somebody and you're not seeing the results that you know are waiting for them because you can see it, but they're just not ready to receive it, that's not your responsibility. And that memory is how I remain neutral. When somebody is not cooperating, when my son is not listening and he's doing exactly the thing that is going to cause him all the grief, and I'm going to have to listen to the grief, but I know at this point, this is their path, their growth. Some people need it to be hard. Some people are okay with it being easy. And that's how I stay neutral. So that might help you stay neutral as well.
Yeah, and it's kind of funny, some of the stories about, you know, the way you're raising your son is to be very aware of his choices.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And that's so important for everyone. And so everybody taking responsibility for all their choices. So we just strengthen that. That's just your ability to be able to respond to life's little challenges and what we're doing and, you know, in life. And so Liz, how are you doing right now? How are you feeling? The energy is really charged. You're really like pumped.
Yeah, really good. With the, you know, what had gotten cleared, you know, when I worked with you and starting on the radio show last week, you know, there had really been this really uncomfortable anxiety around some work in one particular client, and that got, you know, just disappeared. And, you know, the freedom since that is, you know, so great, and then be able to sort of see that little more, kind of just cleared the way to then also see more of maybe the nuances of, you know, what Will was saying, you know, just allowing, you know, be myself, having fun, and that, you know, sometimes still not feeling anxiety, but kind of the story that, well, if I'm sort of doing my piece correctly, then this person, their stress is going to be gone or whatever, and getting them, no, that part is over there with them. You know, that only happens if they're ready to receive it.
And Will, yeah. I still say, I think, have you phoned in before and had Will energetically shift you on this radio show?
No, I haven't with Will. I'm a pretty regular caller, but first time with Will.
Cool. Because what's coming up, it must just be, it's an energetic shift that's coming through that he just did then that, or it has done for you, that, you know, of excitement, of getting into the excitement of what you're doing and recognizing sometimes anxiety, excitement. We want to just strengthen everyone out there. When I say excitement, I don't mean that feeling that you get from your adrenal glands when you're in fight or flight, but more of an excitement of like, oh, like I'm doing what I want to do. I was just saying this to Will yesterday because he's working on my dragon sight, and just, you know, the fact that it's getting out there and it's getting done, I'm so excited. Like, I can't sleep at night. I've been up painting, and, you know, I've done like, what, 7-8 paintings since I got back from Peru. And I'm like, you know, I've written like, I don't know, 120 pages for a book already again. Like, it's just, I'm in a real creative flow here.
Inspired joy.
There we go. And the dragons are all going, yay, you know. So it's energetically, like, I'm just having a lot of fun right now. And so I really want to put that out to you. And, you know, I'm so happy that you had such a great result from the work we've been doing together. I can really feel that things are really moving into a beautiful way for you. So thank you for calling in.
Oh, you're so welcome. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Liz.
Okay.
And,
take care.
Bye-bye.
Will, I want to touch base on this because just before she mentioned it, you were, when we were on the break, you were talking about this, you know, about our ancestors' stuff around this, you know, that, you know, if we're not working hard and we're not slugging it out and we're, you know, like talk about that a little bit.
Okay. So this I can tie back into some of the books I've been reading. The new Aeon, you know, we talked about the end of the Mayan calendar. There's a little bit of fuzziness around the exact date of the coming of the new Aeon. But then what is this new Aeon supposed to be all about? It is about the emancipation of the human race. And what does that really mean? You know, what is emancipation? That's when I tell my parents that the way they do things just doesn't work for me and I'm going to go do my thing somewhere else. And I look at how I see that in the world around me. And I'm recognizing that every generation for the last, I don't know, 5-10 generations has been letting go of more and more and more and more of how our ancestors did things. And here we stand at a place where the world is so critically changed and so primed for more that I couldn't even begin to prepare my son for the world he's going to grow up in. I can only prepare him to take care of himself when he gets there.
That's true.
We're moving very quickly right now into this place of new ability in creation. And I've been reading some material talking about this whole Christ consciousness and the second coming and what does that really mean? And it's been mentioned many times now as us coming into the ability to create as we read that Christ did, which is simply, I see it in my mind, I see it in my heart, it becomes real in front of me, whether it's a healing or whether it's another physical manifestation. But everything I'm reading says that we're letting go of what everybody has been holding on to for so long is reality, and we're embracing this new infinite potential that stands in front of us. It's pretty, pretty amazing.
Amen.
Oh,
I love that. Oh, we're at the end of the show here, and so I want to thank you so much for sharing your time and energy with us today, and just share your contact again for thoughts.
Thank you. Thoughts, THOUGHTS at this agree. THISAGREE.CA.
And I just wanted to mention also, people have been asking me, am I doing that teleshifting before I leave for Europe? I'm not going to have time, but I'm going to schedule it for right when I come back. The dragons have been like a lot of work this this last couple of weeks, and just like really moving into getting all of this done before I leave on the 15th of March to do the seminar there. So I want to thank everybody. Thank you for all the wonderful reviews I'm getting from the book. And once again, thank you, Will. Thank you, Brian. Thank you, listeners. We will be
thank
back
you.
Next week. 8 o'clock a.m. Pacific time to make some more shift happen.
You've been listening to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stefan. Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stefan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network as she provides energetic shifts and consistent results in every area of life, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. The Truth Is Funny. Visit thetruthisfunny.com for more information. That's thetruthisfunny.com.